everyone, and welcome to Video Game Book Club, a show where we cover more than just Nintendo games. No, wait a minute, that can't be right. Just Nintendo games? Nintendo? Conkers? DuckTales? Earthbound? Flintstones? Final Fantasy? Oh man. What? None of that really matters right now, because we're going to cover a Sega Genesis game. That's right. But it's a Mega Man Sega Genesis game. Now that you've had some time to let that sink in just a little bit, I actually meant the Mega Drive. We only got this game on the Genesis if you had the Sega Channel. And that game is Mega Man, The Wily War. A Mega Man game on a Sega console. Let's check this out. Known as Rockman Mega World in Japan, Mega Man The Wily Wars is a compilation of remakes by Capcom for the Sega Mega Drive, released in 1994. The difference between The Wily Wars and compilations like the Anniversary Collection that appeared on the PlayStation 2 and Xbox is that this was billed as somewhat of a sequel to the original three Mega Man games on the NES. Instead of just a pure compilation with some added content here and there. Even though that's basically what it is. A glorified compilation with a fancy name and an optional bonus game. However, unless you lived in Japan or the PAL regions, you didn't have access to a physical version. Here in North America, we could only play the Wily Wars on the Sega Channel. And you won't get this from the actual game, but according to the manual, Dr. Wily has traveled back in time in an attempt to stop Mega Man from destroying the original Robot Masters in one of their first three meetings. Man, they really added to the story there, didn't they? Some good news for the casual player is that the Wily Wars makes use of battery saves. Now you don't need to play through Mega Man 1 in a single setting. You can save after you defeat a Robot Master, or, you know, lose all your lives, because you probably will. Unfortunately, though, this meant losing the famous password system from 2 and 3, but I'm oddly okay with that. One minor annoyance is that once you select which game you want to play, there's no way out if you accidentally select the wrong one. Only a reset of the system will get you back. The Wily Wars gives a bit of a bump to the graphics of the classic Mega Man games on the NES, taking them from 8-bit to 16-bit. Unfortunately, they also attempted to update the music, which they never should have done. Just listen to the differences between the Mega Man 2 title screens. Personally, I prefer the classic 8-bit tunes of the NES versions. Nothing against 16-bit music at all, I just think they did a piss-poor job on recreating these. I mean, Proto Man's whistle is almost unbearable now. We all know the premise behind Mega Man. You fight through levels and defeat Robot Masters. Then you fight through Wily's castle and you defeat Dr. Wily. This can be a tough task in the Wily Wars, especially if you're Daniel. It's not that this game is any more difficult than the originals, but the controls don't feel as tight as they did on the NES. This time, a lot of deaths truly aren't your fault. Daniel, your excuse is now valid.
Finally, some redemption!
On top of the spotty controls, the Wily Wars suffers from extreme lag at times, and can make playing through certain sections almost unbearable. The Yellow Devil stage suffers the most from this. However, for those less skilled players, Daniel, this can actually make the fight much easier. Wow. Platforming in Mega Man is hard anyway. Platforming with lag and moving objects is a huge pain in the ass. Once you make your way completely through all three games, you unlock an optional bonus game, simply called Wily Tower. Dr. Wily has created three new robot masters that act as guardians of the tower, ready to destroy Mega Man. Boy, you heard this story before. These three robot masters make up what is called the Genesis Unit, because Sega. Duh. They are also based on characters from the Chinese novel Journey to the West. These robot masters are Buster Rod G, Mega Water S, and Hyperstorm H. Hyperstorm H is kind of an asshole. He's the only robot master to have two energy gauges. Sweet. At the start of Wily Tower, you have the option to pick 8 of the 22 weapons from Mega Man 1, 2, and 3. You can also choose 3 out of the 7 transport items from those games as well. You may be saying, well, what if I don't want to take anything?
Well, what if I don't want to take anything?
You don't have to, but that just seems like a silly thing to do. Look, I'm not going to tell you what weapons to bring along, but I highly suggest you should at least bring Hard Knuckle, Hyper Bomb, Firestorm, and Ice Slasher. Because, I mean, you never know. One of these robot masters could be weak to, you know, one of those. Maybe 2 or 3 or 4. I don't know. After you play through the three new robot masters, another Dr. Wily stage opens up. In typical Wily Castle fashion, you play through this tower in stages with mini-boss battles throughout before finally reaching Dr. Wily and his crazy machine. Once Dr. Wily is defeated and the castle crumbles, Mega Man is shown chasing after the evil doctor while the robot master names scroll past. Honestly, I'm not that upset that we never saw the physical release of Wily Wars here in North America. Because games like Mega Man the Anniversary Collection offer so much more. You get the first 8 games, plus 2 bonus games that saw very limited release outside of Japan. Plus, the controls aren't shit, and KJ Inafune never called this game an absolute nightmare to work on. I was extremely excited when I heard that I could get Mega Man the Wily Wars on my Genesis, but then extremely disappointed after I played it. I mean, it's a good game and all, it's just not a great game. But I want to hear from you all. Have any of you all played it? And if you have, leave a comment down below and let me know what you thought about it. And if you liked this video in any way, give me a big thumbs up and also hit that subscribe button and you'll be able to find out more of what we're doing with our channel. Again, thanks a lot for listening, guys, and I'll see you all in the next one.
Thanks for watching our video. We appreciate it.
Yeah, we know you all are busy, and we love that you've taken time to hang out with us for a little while.
While you're here, why don't you check out some of our other videos we've made? You kind of owe us now.
And we have a website that you can browse through too, you know, if you want to.
You can also check us out on Twitter and Facebook. All those links are right here, so it's easy.
If you want to see more stuff from us, go ahead and subscribe if you haven't already, and also leave this video a big thumbs up. That would be super awesome. Well, until next time, take care, everyone.